नमस्कार, आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कृतिका दे फ्रॉम एलजे स्कूल ऑफ लॉ. विल बी डीलिंग विद आईपीसी टुडे, ऑफ कोर्स, एंड अंडर आईपीसी विल बी डीलिंग विद द टॉपिक कॉल्ड स्टोलन प्रॉपर्टी. यू हैव रेड अबाउट थेफ्ट, यू रेड अबाउट रॉबरी, बट वट इज इन स्टोलन प्रॉपर्टी? हाउ डू वी गेट टू नो दैट द प्रॉपर्टी इज स्टोलन? Now, everything will get cleared when we'll see this very section and we'll see the ingredients of this section. So let's get started. So when it comes to stolen property, it is mentioned under section 410 of Indian Penal Code. And now you can see these familiar terms: theft, extortion, robbery, criminal misappropriation, criminal breach of trust. So I guess if we read stolen property, these things will be revised as well. So it is good. The revision as well as understanding new section. Isn't that great? Let's read the section. The section says, as per the section, if a property will be termed as stolen property, a property will be termed as stolen property, if its possession has been transferred by any of the following ways. Now you can see a property will be termed as a stolen property if the possession is transferred by any of these. So if a property been taken by theft or extortion, robbery, criminal misappropriation or criminal breach of trust, now the property which is gained by any of these is now being given to the other person, right? And now if somebody has the property because of any of these, let that be theft, extortion, robbery, criminal misappropriation or criminal breach of trust, then it will be taken as, or it will be termed as, in stolen property. So here, as I was saying, that when the property is gained by any of these five things, then the property is stolen, right? The property will be termed as in stolen property. So here, let's revise these five things. Now, do you remember what is theft? Now, in theft, we could say that dishonestly gaining the possession or taking the property out of the legal possession of the other party, that is theft, right? Me taking, for say A is there and B is there. Let's take quick examples in order to understand these five, so that we can even, it will lead to revision as well. So A and B are there, right? And here, A is here, B is here. B had a very beautiful pen. Let's take a very small example. B had a very beautiful pen. Now B went somewhere else and A just takes that very movable property. Now when it comes to theft, the subject matter has to be movable. Now A took that very pen from B, right? So here A committed theft because it was with regard to a movable property. It was in the possession of B, right? And he took that very pen out of the possession of B, of course, with the fraudulent intention. So here A has committed theft. Okay, now quickly, what do we mean by extortion? By extortion, we mean that putting somebody under the fear of injury. Now here, injury could be of reputation or of body, any injury. Right? And then by putting that person under that fear, forcing him to or asking him to deliver the property. Right? So here you put that person under a fear of injury. Injury could be like, I will publish that thing about you, or I will publish that photograph, that, you know, one secret photograph of yours in the newspaper if you do not transfer me your property. So that would lead to extortion. Now, robbery. Do you remember in robbery, we have read that in every robbery, there is either theft or extortion. So now when it comes to robbery, if during committing, let's take the first one, if while committing theft, if there is instant death, hurt or wrongful restraint, or the fear of instant death, hurt or wrongful restraint, then it will lead to robbery, right? It will lead to robbery. Same, let's take the case under extortion also. When it comes to extortion, firstly, in this case, in this extortion, in general extortion, you know, there could be a call, a simple call that you just transfer that property, otherwise I'll put something, I'll publish something, or I'll harm you. But the person is not an immediate presence. But when it comes to robbery, when extortion is getting converted into robbery, the other person has to be in front of the other person to whom he is actually giving that warning, right? And that warning should be of death, instant death, hurt, or wrongful restraint to him or to any person to whom he is interested in. And of course, he has to be in front of that person. So it has to be of that instant nature. Then it will be robbery. I hope you are getting everything in mind because we have read those lectures. So, and here also it is important if you have not. So it is important for me to explain these to you so that you understand what stolen property is. The next one is criminal misappropriation. You remember criminal misappropriation of property? It means that property was not in possession of anybody. You found, let me give you one example. You found a note on the road, right? You just picked up that very note. Okay, you picked up that very note. And here, how will that be a criminal misappropriation? Though you did not take that very note from anybody. Okay, but you saw that very, very 100 rupee note or 500 rupee note falling down from somebody's purse, and that somebody is still walking. You could see that person, right? And when you picked it up, that did not amount to criminal misappropriation, because till then your intention was, okay, let me give it back to that person. But as soon as you took it, you thought of actually using it for your own purpose. So when you got that very intention of using it for your own purpose and you put that back in your pocket, even having the means of giving back to the person to whom it actually belongs, you actually thought of using it for yourself and you put that back in your pocket, that leads to criminal misappropriation. Right now, criminal breach of trust, as you can see, there has to be a relation of trust between two parties. And then there is a breach. For breach, there has to be trust first. So first, say there is an employer and employee relationship. He delegated some of the work to the employee. And then employee broke that very trust. He asked that his employee to sell some of the furnitures to the other person or anything. But he actually misused it and he used it for his own purpose. So that is criminal breach of trust, because there was a relation of trust here and then there was a breach of it. So these are these terms. So if any property has been gained by any of these five, then property is known as the stolen property. Now let's see if it comes to dishonestly receiving stolen property. Now what happens if we know the definition of stolen property. Now, if somebody, the person who has it is by default is booked under these sections, right? You get my point. When if somebody has the property out of criminal misappropriation, that person would be booked under criminal misappropriation. But now, the second one, if somebody has gained property out of theft, then he will be booked under theft. But what if that person has sold that very property gained out of theft, extortion, robbery, or when it comes to criminal misappropriation, right, or criminal breach of trust? If after gaining that property, if he transfers the possession to the other party, now that other party will be liable under this section. Now what this section says, the section says whoever dishonestly receives or retains any stolen property, knowing or having reason to believe the same to be stolen property, shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 3 years, or with fine, or with both. Now here, there are two things, either receiving, right, or retaining it. Retaining what? Retaining the stolen property. But now what makes it an offense? Knowing or having reason to believe the same to be stolen. Now, if here the person is innocently keeping, for say, A steals something really big, maybe gold or maybe diamond from any third party, and he gives the same to his girlfriend, right? And he had been telling since a long time that, you know, I'm saving for your birthday, or I'm saving for our marriage, or whatsoever. So that girl must have thought that maybe he might have saved for the gold and now he's giving me the ring. So she did not know, of course, firstly, and she had no reason to believe that the property must be stolen. She thought that he might have saved, right? Let's take another example. A guy, never of that very feeling, never had any means to earn properly so that he can gift a ring to his wife or gift a ring to any third person. Now, if he does so, the other person might get a thought that this must be stolen because he had no means to earn it. He had never mentioned it. So now when the person had that very thing in the mind, that from where he must have got that ring. So at least they have, or she or he had the reason to believe, the same to be a stolen property. Then that person will be booked under this section and the imprisonment may go to 3 years or with fine or with both, right? So it applies to the next party. The immediate party will be booked under the sections that we have seen. But what about the other party who has actually received that stolen property with the knowledge or with the reason to have that belief that property must be stolen? Then this section applies to that party. We have seen it, and now let's see dishonestly receiving property stolen in the commission of a dacoity. Now that is there under section 148. Now the ingredients are the property is a stolen property. The said property was concerned with the dacoity, right? When it comes to dacoity, 5 or more people, right? The accused dishonestly deceived it. The accused knew or has reason to believe the property to be stolen. Then it would be dishonestly receiving property stolen the commission of a dacoity. Same as that, but the section is different. That is section 412. So when it comes to that very thing, when it is a stolen property out of dacoity, right? Supposingly A has committed dacoity and A has given the same to B, and B has complete knowledge that the property is stolen. Now that is a stolen property out of dacoity. Now that person will be charged with imprisonment, that is rigorous imprisonment up to 10 years or imprisonment for life. The imprisonment is huge here, and with fine. So fine is not an option here, it is and with fine. So by now, I guess we are done with the revisions of previous sections or previous sections of Indian Penal Code. And also we got to know a new section, that is stolen property. So with this, I would like to rest my lecture. Keep studying, keep revising. Thank you.